Today we have the pleasure of meeting with the new chief in town, Sheriff's Office Lieutenant Ed Barberini, and he's going to answer all of my questions. He's not going to hold anything back. So let's all get to meet Ed Barberini. Hello, thank you for being here.
Hi, thank you for having me.
So tell me, who are you and where did you come from?
Well, my name's Ed Barberini. I'm relatively local. I was raised in Burlingame, just next door. Attended school as a youngster in Burlingame. When I reached high school age, I went up to San Francisco, attended St. Ignatius High School in San Francisco. Stayed local. I graduated from San Francisco State University with an undergraduate degree and was hired by the sheriff's office in my early 20s.
And here you are.
Here I am.
Here you are.
Came full circle.
So I understand that you have two master's degrees?
That's correct.
Tell me about your master's degrees.
Well, I have a master's degree from what was formerly known as Hayward State. It was Hayward State University when I was there. I believe now it's California State University at East Bay in public administration with an emphasis on public policy. And then more recently, I earned a master's degree from the Naval Postgraduate School in Homeland Security Studies.
So that's your schooling.
Yep.
And that's where you're from. But I'd like to get inside this person here. Tell me a couple of your hobbies. Tell me what you're interested in.
I'm a big Giants fan. This is a great time of year for me. Opening day being tomorrow, right around the corner. Spring training is always exciting. I'm not only a San Francisco Giants fan, I spend a lot of time watching the San Jose Giants, a minor league team in San Jose. Avid reader. I read a lot.
So what are you reading right now?
I'm reading a book called Unbroken. And I wish I could remember the author's name. I don't, but it's about a World War II veteran and his experiences growing up in World War II. But this is my favorite time of year. Summertime is an exciting time for me. I like the long days and be outdoors.
Have you ever been to spring training?
Oh yes, been to spring training several times.
That's a lot of fun, huh?
A lot of fun. It's gotten more and more popular. So I remember when you could go and just kind of walk up and buy a ticket. But
right.
With the success of the Giants recently and baseball growing more popular, it's a little bit more hectic and tougher to get around down there. So I haven't been in a few years, but I enjoy spring training as well as going to see the Giants when they're here.
Well, you're certainly going to find a lot of people in town when you go down to Starbucks or wherever it is that you go for
sure.
Your cup of coffee who are Giants fans.
That's true.
So you got something in common there. I've noticed that around here in the police cars and over in the sheriff's department, we've got a couple of familiar faces. Doesn't seem that things have changed a whole bunch, but go ahead and tell me whose faces I recognize from Millbrae who are still here.
Well, during the day, you're going to see some of the more senior Millbrae officers who transitioned over to the sheriff's office. You're going to see Officer Gabby Chikuri, who works days on one team, and then his counterpart on the other day shift is Officer Jim Abood, who were been around a long time. They know a lot about the city. We're very fortunate to have them. Possess a great deal of knowledge, as do our two night shift officers who transferred over to the sheriff's office. Steve O'Malley, who's got a real strong knowledge with the schools, working with the community. Very happy to have him, as well as Garrett Penn, who's a younger Millbrae officer who stayed on with the sheriff's office. But the knowledge and the familiarity they bring to our efforts here have been invaluable. The transition to this point has been great. I think they're enjoying themselves in this environment, and we are more than happy to have them on the team, so to speak.
Well, and I know there are two more faces that we're going to see, but before I ask you about that, I'm going to say that I know that Steve O'Malley just won an area-wide service award from the Peninsula Council of Lions for his service with the Explorers. So congratulations to Steve O'Malley.
Yes, Friday night, I think it was last Friday night, he was awarded that award. We're looking forward to drawing on his experience too. I've talked to Steve about getting involved in our Explorer program and lending his experience to that effort. And we're excited to have him on board. We think that'll work out well.
And at MCTV, we have worked with Steve O'Malley many times over at Mills High School on joint projects. We worked with him on the Every 15 Minutes program and some of the other fine stuff that goes on over there. So speaking of schools, we're going to be seeing a familiar face as a school service officer?
Yes, Officer or Deputy Dan Young, who has a long history in Millbrae, was a Millbrae officer for quite a long time, and came over to the sheriff's office several years ago, lateraled over as a sheriff's deputy. I've known Dan a long time. We worked together when he was with Millbrae. He was the vehicle theft task force while I was the narcotics task force. We were co-located there for a while, so we worked side by side. So I've known Dan for quite some time. It's great walking around the city with him recently. He sees a lot of familiar faces. A lot of folks remember him. Obviously, think very highly of him based on the reception that we've seen, and already has made his presence felt in the schools and in the community. So he won't be here alone or on an island. He'll have the support of our school resource unit, but he'll be the point person for the city. And it's obviously a great choice because of his background here. So we're excited to have Dan on board.
That's wonderful, and we're excited to have him back.
Yes.
Yes, and especially since he was active with our Cop Talk program many years ago.
Oh.
And there's one more face over at the police department that we might recognize?
Yeah, you may recognize Deputy Eric Myrtle. He was, a Millbrae officer for quite some time and lateraled over to the sheriff's office several years ago before the transition took place. He's going to be helping out in an interim basis. He'll be mainly inside the police department there. So. If you come walk up and need some help at the front window and you need some support from a deputy, you're likely to find Eric standing on the other side of the counter there helping you out. We don't know how long we're going to be able to hold on to Eric. Obviously, we're going to make every effort to keep him with us as long as we can, but we're happy to have him here while we can keep him. So we're grateful for that.
Well, that's just great. That's just great. So now, in your previous description there, you mentioned narcotics. You've had a number of interesting assignments with the sheriff's office. Can you tell me what some of them are?
Sure. One of the benefits of working for an organization like the sheriff's office is the fact that you get to do a lot of different things. And I think that's what's exciting for some of the newer officers that came over from Millbrae during the transition. I think they recognize that, and I think they're seeing the benefits of that now. I started at a fairly young age and kind of paid my dues, so to speak, working in the jail for a year or so. I went and worked in patrol. I spent a lot of time in patrol in the city of East Palo Alto when the sheriff's office provided service there. As a deputy early on, and then as I promoted to sergeant, I got to go back and serve as a sergeant for the East Palo Alto Police Department, kind of on a loan basis, which was a nice experience. But as you mentioned, I was able to spend about six or so years in narcotics at our countywide narcotics task force. What's nice about those types of opportunities is they're not confined to one agency or one organization. They all have they're a multi-agency or multi-jurisdictional approach. So you get to know a lot more people. You become more familiar with how things work from police department to police department or city to city. I was lucky enough to be assigned to a street crimes team that was actually located at the Redwood City Police Department. We worked in conjunction with some Redwood City officers. So again, it's a different environment working in a sheriff's office as opposed to a police department. So especially, I was fairly young then, and as a young deputy, that was a great opportunity to kind of see how police department functions to compare and contrast to what I was used to at the sheriff's office. So I've been lucky. More recently, I had a fairly unique assignment at the Office of Emergency Services and Homeland Security, and that's a countywide organization. It's actually governed by a representative from each city and a member of the Board of Supervisors. So it was a challenge to kind of be taken out of a traditional sheriff's office role, answering to not only one county or one city, but actually 20 cities, 20 entities. Which was a challenge.
And you did mountain rescue, and you did offshore rescue, and you did all kinds of special things, and you have a master's in Homeland Security.
Well, it all kind of worked out. The fun part about that job was you do get to manage all the cool, interesting units at the
Send the helicopters, yes. Send the airplanes.
Yeah, the one good thing, and I think it's going to work out well with the city, is a lot of our technical expertise at the sheriff's office when it comes to rescue capabilities and those sort of things are volunteer based, and the volunteers actually possess a greater expertise than many of our paid staff when it comes to those types of things. I think in the transition with Millbrae, the heavy volunteer influence or presence within the military police or within the Millbrae Police Department kind of made things nice for the transition. At the sheriff's office, we rely on volunteers. So welcoming those volunteers kind of into the sheriff's office fold as part of an existing group of volunteers was great. It would have been a little bit more difficult if we had not had the background with dealing with volunteers, but I think that the fact that we had that, and I was fortunate to be in the position where we managed those volunteer units, made things a little bit easier for us.
So I would guess that our police explorers and our police volunteers are going to have some more opportunities if they're now involved in the sheriff's organization.
Yeah, the nice thing for all the volunteers, Millbrae and otherwise, is they get to expand their horizons. If you were a Millbrae police volunteer, now you have the opportunity to continue to do the same things you've always done, to do the same things within the city, perform the same duties that have always been there. But you're going to be offered other opportunities. There are special events throughout the year, throughout the county. We have the Pumpkin Festival in Half Moon Bay, which is a large event. We have the North Fair Oaks Festival down in Redwood City, sponsored by the Sheriff's Office, very large event. San Carlos has the Hometown Days, which is a large event. Dream Machines at the Half Moon Bay Airport, which is a big deal, as well as the Art and Wine Festival here. So those things don't just happen by themselves. And without volunteers, they'd be very much, very expensive and cost a lot more than they already do to put on, and may probably wouldn't run as smoothly. So if you are a Millbrae volunteer and you like doing what you're doing, that's great. Well, but you'll also have the opportunities to kind of expand your horizons and work in other parts of the county. And for the sheriff's office volunteers, they're going to have an opportunity to come into the city and do the same thing. So it's I think it's a win-win for everybody.
It's a win-win.
Yeah.
All right, so now I don't want to make you uncomfortable now.
Okay.
Don't consider this a dumb question, but who is your boss? I mean, who do you answer to?
Well, I work for the city of Millbrae. The city of Millbrae is, that's who I answer to. The city manager is, I take direction from Marsha Raines, the city manager, and work with her, through her, with the council, as far as to meet any city needs. Obviously, I work within the sheriff's office structure. I'm a lieutenant within that structure, so there is a captain and an undersheriff, and ultimately the sheriff within that chain of command. However, they are conscious of my relationship with the city. They understand the importance of that. I actually interact more regularly with the city manager and city staff than I do with anybody, of rank at the sheriff's office. Just based out of necessity.
Could I characterize it as your duties are dictated by the city council and the city manager and your budget is dictated by the sheriff's department?
I think that's fairly fair to say. Our goal here is to meet the needs of the city. Their priorities are our priorities. The budget is basically based on the contractual agreement between the city and the county, so that makes things a little bit easier on me, in my relationship with the city, as opposed to a traditional police chief city manager relationship, where I'd have to develop the budget, maybe advocate for my budget with the city manager. Because there is a contract in place, the budget is fairly static, and we know what it's going to be for the next couple of years. So that's one benefit that I enjoy. However, it's not like it's a unlimited budget, so I have to make sure that we manage that budget efficiently and correctly so that we can meet the needs of the city while staying within those parameters.
So we may see you around town. I'm hoping that you're going to be very visible so that people who see you at Starbucks or at Pete's or at Safeway or something can come up to you and say, I'm reading the same book you are. Tell me about spring training. I love the Giants, or whatever they'd like to talk about. Maybe there's some other ones who came from Burlingame. I hope people come up and say hello to you. I think you're going to be a fixture around town. I very much appreciate the time that you spent with us today. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it. Thank you.